Okay, so yeah, thank you for your interest in my presentation. I work at the GFZ Potsdam with Martin Herold, and we are also part of the Open Earth Monitor project, user engagement mainly. And I'm not sure if someone was here at the last conference one year ago. There was Nuno Cesar-Desar presenting already this survey result. And we have extended the survey. We made a new promotional round and increased the responses to more than 40%. And yeah, so today I will present the new results, more or less, but also confirming the results of Nuno. So, to bring a bit the FAIR data in the context of Open Earth Monitor, our work is within the work package 2, and we want to understand user gaps and needs, and also help to make platforms more fair. So, improve accessibility of data with open source licenses and so on. Okay, FAIR data principles. Maybe not everyone is totally aware what it means. So these four letters stand for F, findability. So that means provide your data in machine-readable format with metadata, with unique identifiers, and also the public accessibility is essential. So the A stands for accessibility and should ensure that data is readily available to users. And then there is the interoperability, means that we can share our data, or we can combine it with other data sources, and so on. And the R is reusability, so the meaning that I can reuse my data, or data can be reused by other researchers, for instance. And there are always challenges related to these principles, of course. There's also a list of really detailed criteria, and I will not go through this now, this is too theoretic. So let's start with the survey. So the survey was on the website of the EU, I'll show you then, was composed of 3 blocks. I think it took around 10-15 minutes for the people. It addressed first the background, general information of the respondents, inquired about the characteristics of geospatial data that were used and produced, because the survey was focused on users on the one hand and on producers of data. So you had to select which one you are, and then the question went in different directions. And then finally, the most important was to investigate how these users or producers are familiar with the FAIR principles, and if they use the FAIR principles in data production, and which are most relevant. So we tried to make a sounds fancy target-specific participant selection. So we tried to get a representative data set of respondents, which was partly achieved, partly not. The survey was open, is still open, but we will close it soon because we also plan to make a scientific paper out of it. And we take the final results of these last weeks, and then we will close it. And we had 170 responses with 74.5% of users and 26% of users, which I think is fine, because obviously there are more producers and more users than producers. And then there is not the best gender balance with 68% male. Okay, so regarding the background, most of the respondents were researchers working in research institutions or universities, but there were also companies, government, public administration were also present, so this was fine. We had from the field of application, we had from agriculture, land degradation, the most background, and also nature conservation, biodiversity. I mean, at the end, all these applications were covered, and this was also satisfying. And the map on the right-hand side shows a bit the global distribution, so the dark areas are not covered, but the light blue. But overall, which is not so well visible here, we had around 80% of the respondents from Europe, and most from Germany. So maybe the key question here, are you familiar with FAIR data? we found that the users are much less aware of their data than producers. So looking at the dark blue, this means users were not familiar at all. So 30% of the users were not familiar at all with their data. And when I think about myself, about my background, it was I'm coming also from a poor research university work, and we were not really aware of fair data. Nobody was talking about fair data. So I think this this awareness has to be increased now. It's important. But also the producers, data producers, are also not so familiar with 23% not familiar at all. So this, this graph shows somehow the confirmation of the share of knowledge before. So 70% of 75% of data producers provide fair or partially at least fair data, but only 20% of the users have worked with fair data. Then regarding types of geospatial data, we have, it's maybe a bit small, the letters, but most users and producers worked with open satellite, remote sensing-based and derived products, and also in situ data. So between two groups, this was more or less similar regarding all the different types of data. But where we found a discrepancy, this is the scale where people produce data. So the producers focus more on the global level, on the continental, while a user is more interested in country-level data or in local data. So what are the important features for these user and producers groups? So the data are online findable, easy to find online and open. This is the most important. So for the majority of the respondents. Open and findable, but also that they are clear documented and that there's a license, and also metadata are important. Here we grouped the producers and users group together, and on this slide users and producers are separated, but more or less it's visible that there's a similar share and interest in these different aspects of the fair data characteristics. So what is the problematic features? Again, this confirms what I said before. The most problematic feature of fair data for people is that data are not open. But also I have to say that fair does not mean open always, and open is not always fair. So here's maybe also some confusion from people. So this fair does not mean open, it's just fair. So there are these principles. Yeah, and again, incomplete, poor metadata is a big problem, and also data formats, which are not compatible, and so on. This final, the second last question, focuses on the four FAIR principles, but there are six questions. But here it was again visible that data must be easily accessible. So easy to find, easy accessible, this is most important. But overall, we can see that all these criteria are important. And the green color of not important almost does not appear. So fair is important, also not yet so well known and used. So the final key question: what are the biggest barriers to use for users or to produce for data producers? More fair data. People could select several. And so interestingly, the producer said, we have a lack of resources. So in lack of resources and of costs, of personnel, of time, also missing incentives. And this must be improved. On the user side, it's more the lack of awareness. So people don't know about fair. They don't know about the benefits and select guidelines. The conclusion, main takeaway. This FAIR survey was conducted with 170 responses and in a diversity of geographies, so mostly focusing on Europe was also the project. And we had 75% of data users. So most data producers work on global level, while the users focus on national and local level. And this can, of course, bring problems. I think was mentioned in the presentation before, because on the national level there are specificities, and when you produce data on a global level, it may be very uncertain when you go to a region. The level of familiarity, there is varies a lot, so we have 60% versus 40% between users and producers. And from the principles, people want to have data quick and easy to find and accessible online. This is very important. So having data open and fair at an equal level is important, because as I said before, it's not the same always. For the Open Earth Monitor project, here we have working package 3 and 6, and these also work on creating the essential fair technical infrastructure. So there is work to find this data easily and make it accessible and so on. So the Open Earth Monitor project aims to overcome the producers' obstacles in terms of investments and also incentives and so on. And for the stakeholder engagement, here is the key to engage in a dialogue between user producers, and so what we will do in the use cases in the next months. So focus should be on explaining fair data, making them more aware, and produce this data and demonstrate the good value in practice. Okay, so that's all from my side, and happy to have here any questions.